Hi everybody, we're here today at Disney's Beach Club Resort and Villas. We're gonna go ahead and do a resort tour. Let's do this. Hi everybody. So we've been staying here at the Beach Club for a couple of nights and we really enjoy it. And we've been staying in a two-bedroom villa on the DVC side. And when you approach the Beach Club villas, this is what you'll see when you first pull in. Get dropped off with your airport transfer or a taxi, or if you rented a car, this is where you would pull in to check in. They even have this old car here for the kids to play on. You can get in right there, take pictures, play like you're driving an old car. Now we're going to go ahead and walk into the main lobby. Lobby over here to the right is where you check in. Over there's Cape May Cafe. If you walk straight out those doors there, that'll take you to the boardwalk area, which we are actually across Crescent Lake. And over here on the left, when you first walk in, is Bell Services. That's where you can check your luggage while you're waiting for your room to be ready, or hold it on your last day for you to get to the park and after you check out. Here's a map of the resort. So as you can see, we're right here in the middle. Sorry. No, we're actually right here. There's Stormalong Bay. There's Crescent Lake. Underneath that, they actually have a resort shopping and dining options laid out here, right underneath the map. This is all right here in the lobby. Going a little further towards the left. So we have a Disney Cruise Line on display. That's the Dream. Here's your Disney Vacation Club desk. So when you are a DVC member, or if you're interested in DVC, this is where you can come to ask about an open house. They usually have a villa on display for people to come check it out, or current members to come check out what a beach club villa might look like. This is all right here in the lobby. So here's the Beach Club Marketplace. This is basically a souvenir shop along with a quick service. So here's some Beach Club specific merch. This Beach Club Resort shirt is $24.99. That's kind of nice. They have these robes on display. Seaside is where I belong. Disney's Beach Club Villa. Let's see. That's $26.99. There's a little memento you can hang up in your house. This piece of art is $50. This corksicle is $39.99. There's a nice little pullover. Another shirt. Another Seaside is where I belong item. So in addition to Beach Club merch, they also just have regular Disney merch. Let's see if we can find some more specific Beach Club merch. Here is where you have the Disney Vacation Club specific merchandise. Here's a ladies' DVC tee that is $36.99. That DVC Tervis is $38.99. Get a DVC photo frame, DVC ornament. I've got one of those at home. A couple of DVC hats. Here's a DVC pullover, as well as a DVC spirit jersey, which is $120. This DVC polo is $49.99. Here they've got some of their home collection. Plates, towels, silverware, pillows, blankets, stuff for the kitchen and home. This is pretty cool. They have some Winnie the Pooh specific merchandise. Look at this limited time bonus Halloween tote for $24.99 with any purchase of $40 or more. That's nice. Limited time bonus. We've got toys over here. Supplies for going to the pool. Sunglasses, essentials, cough drops, medicine, toiletries, lots of the things you might need while staying here at the Beach Club. A over here is where you can get some snacks and items for the day. If you happen to buy a refillable mug while you're here, this is where you would go to refill it. The refillable mugs are about $21, $22, and they last for 2 weeks. Now they're showing the breakfast menu. So they have a side entrance here. Club Villas this way. So let's go to the villa side of the resort. So Beach Club Villas and Resort is located in the Epcot area, right along Crescent Lake. Good morning. Just across Crescent Lake from Disney's Boardwalk. They have transportation options available, including buses to Disney Springs, Animal Kingdom, Magic Kingdom. You can take a friendship boat to either Epcot or Hollywood Studios, and you can take the Skyliner to Hollywood Studios. And you can also just walk to the International Gateway at Epcot, which would be the quickest way to get to Epcot. It's about an 8-minute walk. Welcome home. Look at this. Lobby of the DVC side. Over here they have the drawing room. Let's go in there and check it out. So they have a TV, places to sit and lounge around, and they have a pool table. Just a place to kind of relax and hang out. They have this little sign here on this table that says, please visit the concierge desk to rent complimentary pool equipment. So that's real nice. They have some of this art up on the wall. All right, let's go see what else. Look at that amazing photo or painting. So over here on this side, this is again, we're on the villa side of the resort. This would be the quiet pool. Pool hours are 7 a.m. to 11 p.m. I got complimentary life jackets for anyone that needs one. So when you pick your DVC room using points here at Disney's Beach Club, there actually isn't any room categories, but you can put in a room request. All right, let's go see what else we can find. Oh, they do have a hot tub over here. So we're back at the main lobby, and I wanted to show you this. This is their September recreational activities. You can scan that QR code for more information. They have family-friendly video games, Bayside Marina rentals. You can actually rent a boat out on Crescent Lake. Poolside activities, Stormalong Bay daily from 12:30 to 3:30. That's when the activities are, not the pool hours. Painting in the Vineyard, Martha's Vineyard Lounge, every Friday from 4 to 6 p.m. Get in touch with your inner artist during this master-led painting class. Sounds fun. That is for ages 12 and up. Campfire, nightly, at 7 to 8. Stormalong Bay Crafts from 2:30 to 3:30. You can do Mickey tie-dye on Sunday, Thursdays, and Saturdays from 4:30 to 6, located near the shipwreck on the beach area. Create your own nautical necklace on Mondays and Wednesdays. Make your own sea salt scrub Tuesdays from 4:30 to 6. They have a fitness center. And then they do Movie Under the Stars out on the beach area. Here's what they have this month. How fun. One thing I did miss earlier, because we went into the marketplace, was this area called the Solarium. It's a nice little area for you to sit. On Disney Plus Day, they were showing Pinocchio in there that night. Nice little place to sit, especially if you're just wanting to come get a cup of coffee in the morning or just relax. Showing Mickey cartoons right now. Okay, we're gonna head back. Go check out Cape May Cafe. Another activity that they have here is you can get a caricature made of yourself. $25 for a black and white, $30 for a color for just your face, or $30 and $40 for your face and body. Frames are $20. And it's Thursday through Sunday from 5 to 10 p.m. How fun. So over here on the right-hand side of the lobby when you walk in, from the main entrance, is Cape May Cafe. It's a breakfast buffet served from 7:30 to 11:30. And here's what they have available for breakfast. And there's kind of a peek into Cape May Cafe. They have these nice little beach umbrellas on display around the area, just as decor, and these curtains. Look at these. They also have sand castles on display. Again, we're walking around the outskirts of Cape May. More sand castles. Each one is just a little different. Corner here is the Martha's Vineyard Lounge. Here's a sign promoting the painting that we were just talking about. Join us for a master-led painting class every Friday here in Martha's Vineyard from 4 to 6, 12 and up, $35. Like I said, this lounge is not open in the mornings, but they are open in the afternoons and evenings. They've got bar service and a couple of appetizers available. Again, I'll post that menu. So we just came out that door by Martha's Vineyard out here towards the pool area. There you can get a peek at Stormalong Bay. We'll come back in a minute, do a full pool tour. Cream Creations. So here's where you go for Beaches and Cream. They actually have a Beaches and Cream to go walk-up window. Here's their menu. They do have alcoholic hard floats and shakes. Assorted beer, hard beverages, and wine. Ice Cream Creations. And then you can get a mini Mickey sink. A fun play on words. Ice cream sandwich or a root beer float. Here's the check-in area for Beaches and Cream, and their hours are from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m., but here is their menu. So right next to Beaches and Cream, they do have an arcade. It is open from 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. Here's how much it costs to play. How it works, and then you just use these stations to get your card or recharge it. Nerf arcade, I've never seen that one. That looks fun. They got the old skee ball. Got some air hockey. Guitar Hero. They've got the Super Shot basketball game. Maybe, this is something fun to do on a rainy day. Hi, we're going to continue this resort tour with one of the perks of staying here at Disney's Beach Club Resort and Villas, and that is the walking distance to Epcot's International Gateway. So we're just going to see how long does it take to walk to Epcot's International Gateway. Let's do this. You have very nice views of Crescent Lake. It's a very scenic walk, walking across from the boardwalk from Disney's Beach Club to Epcot. This side of the resort happens to be the villas side of the resort. If you are a DVC member, you can actually leave through a couple of walkways here. This is one of them. It actually may make your walk just a little shorter. We left out of the path from the main lobby. So again, we'll just see how long does it take. There's a friendship boat right now going from Boardwalk to Beach Club. This path right here would be your closest path from Disney's Beach Club. You can actually try to get one of those rooms right there along that walking path. It would cut your time down by about 2 minutes. So that's Epcot's Friendship Boat Dock that we're approaching. The Skyliner Station is directly next to it. And then you're right there at the International Gateway entrance to Epcot. Very convenient. recording this around 7:45 a.m. I find it always very scenic to watch the Skyliners come in and out of the station and fly overhead. Well, there you have it, folks. We clocked in at just over 4.5 minutes. Not bad, give or take your walking pace. So again, very convenient to stay at Disney's Beach Club Villas. So when you exit out of the main lobby of the Beach Club, those are the doors on the side towards Crescent Lake. Over here on the left, they have volleyball courts. That's the walking path towards Epcot's International Gateway. Here's the Beach Club's beach along Crescent Lake. Here's a sign that's got the Yacht and Beach Club resort activities posted. This walking path is actually just part of the public area and the resort. This walking path goes around Crescent Lake. You can actually follow it to Hollywood Studios or to Epcot or to the boardwalk. Here's their Yacht and Beach Club activities. This is the sand area behind this sign is where they would show those movies under the stars. They have a listing of activities around the resort, along with applicable pricing. Come over here just for a minute. They do have a resort and map. We'll go check that out. Beautiful day out here. It's a little warm, 88 degrees right now. So where the lighthouse is where the Friendship Boat dock is for both Yacht and Beach Club. You can take the Friendship Boat over to Epcot's International Gateway, to the boardwalk, to the Swan and Dolphin, and to Hollywood Studios. Something kind of unique to the Beach Club's pool area, Stormalong Bay, is the fact that the kids' play area, or I should say the kiddie pool and the smaller slide, as well as the big slide, feature pool slide, and this pirate ship is located on the other side of the walking path. So you actually leave the gated area of Stormalong Bay to get to the slide. Definitely kind of unique and something for parents to know about. They have a sign posted here for a running trail. It's 0.8 miles to go around Crescent Lake, starting here, go around the bridge, go around the boardwalk, come back, go around Crescent Lake, be 0.8 miles. This area right here on the other side of the pirate ship is another little sand play area. They've got some activity set up, like a big Connect Four and a beanbag toss. Here's Hurricane Hannah's waterside bar and grill. You can fill up your refillable drink mug, coffee, get some condiments. Let's check out their menu. The other day, my wife and I shared one of the hot dogs and chicken tenders from the kids' meal. It was actually quite good. Open from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m. right now. And then right next to the quick serve location is their bar. I'll go ahead and put that menu up. Hello.
Good morning, how are we doing?
Good, I think I need to get wristbanded.
Meeting, sir. Alright. Stand up real quick. Awesome. Ah, there's the rest of the Lee family. Alrighty, we've been expecting you. Have a good one.
Thank you. Alright. So, because I am staying here at the Beach Club, I was able to get wristbanded. So, Beach Club is a sand bottom pool. So, they have certain areas where you have a beach as part of the pool area. Kids can play in the sand. Tub right here. Here's their lazy river. It can be deep at a few spots, ranging from, I believe, 5 feet to 8 feet. So just be aware of that. So this part of the lazy river connects to this part of the pool. Which is a little shallower in this area, 3 feet. This area of the pool, a little deeper, it's got some waterfalls. It's 4.5 feet deep. So this area of the pool is 5 feet deep. There's the windmill. This area of the pool is actually pretty large. It connects under this bridge. So if you go up these stairs, there's actually a seating area up there. We'll go up there in just a minute. I have a volleyball net set up here. Got some music playing in the background. Keeps on connecting around. And then over here, another area with some sand, more beach chairs. Three and a half feet deep in this area. 4 feet deep over there. And then the big slide from the pirate ship lets out right over there. So it comes all the way from back there, which is across the Crescent Lake walking path, and then lets out right here. So now let's go up here and check out some of the seating areas up here. So you have quite a view here of Stormalong Bay and the beach club. That's the Lazy River. Over there is the sand. Of course, there's sand actually in the bottom of all the pools here. So they have all these loungers up here, and they've even got a pool table up here. Pool cues up on the wall. And the balls are in the pockets. Don't even need to go to guest services to get those. Here's your view on the other side of the deck here. So yeah. Well, that's the tour of Stormalong Bay. Hope you enjoyed it. I think I'm about to go ahead and jump in because, like I said, it's a hot day. Well, that's your tour of Stormalong Bay and the Beach Club Resort. Hope you enjoyed everything. Have a good one.